Hello everyone, and welcome back to another episode of Let's Play Ark the Lad Twilight of the Spirits, featuring me, UltraGamerJ. First off, I want to give a big thank you to Kiefster for subscribing to this channel. Thank you for helping to support the UltraGamerJ nation, or empire, or whatever. And if you have, and if anyone else in my audience has some free time, check his channel out. With that said, Spencer telling Karg that he can do, quote, whatever he likes with Tatjana, oh, that makes me tug the collar of my shirt with an uncomfortable expression on my face. Cue the obligatory Simpsons clip. I don't think us liberating your city that still seems to be in total darkness has anything to do with the booze tasting better. Well, you could at least give us a house here or something, like, in case excrement hits the whirling device. Yeah, I mean, I don't know if I'd say Tatjana is the most heinous villain. I mean, that title seems to go to Darkum. He's the one who looks like a certain character from Persona 2, who looks an awful lot like a certain historical figure from World War II. Hey, I leave the toilet seat down, and then I wipe up anything that spills on the rim of the toilet when I have to take a squirt. What more does she want from me? It's not what you think. They barely know each other. Well, in the sense that they only know each other and that they've... Well, actually, Tatjana's the only one that's been trying to kill him. Karg does not reciprocate those feelings. I think that's a very bad idea, but what would I know? And shock of all shocks, he's not the white mage of our party. Dude, to quote Team 4 Stars Dragon Ball Z Abridged, just take the compliment. Well, we can't gain intel from her if she's dead. Just saying. That sounds like something you would say if you were thinking of trying to sneak a drink, Maru. Oh, Same dialogue. I see being held as a prisoner of war has done nothing to dull Tatiana's sharp tongue.
Thank you.
Dang. We're not even gonna, like, entertain the idea of interrogating T'Challa for what she knows about the Dilsweld Empire? Well, I had to talk to you first. You'll have all the time you need to think when you're in the Hooskow. The Clink. The Gray Bar Hotel. The Stony Lonesome. Personally, I value you, Paulette. I mean, you're the resident ass-kicker of this team. And everyone loves an ass-kicker. Or at least, I love an I love ass-kickers. There's the first one. Yeah, I mean, remember taking advice. Yeah, it's always a good idea to take advice from a faceless NPC you'll probably never see again. That's right, Jerry. Well, I mean, just because you can have kids doesn't mean you should, ma'am. There. Then where? Dang it. Not in here. So there's only one location left. That you? No, it's the other guy. Sometimes you need to know when to fight the battles you can win. Come on. Let me talk. Let me talk to this guy. What if you, like, took the teachings from the two schools and put them together? Wouldn't that be the ideal scenario? I mean, maybe it's like, Gottfried Leibniz and that other guy whose name I can't remember. Go that way. But then how would we travel from continent to continent? Well, I have some simple advice for you, new guy. Step one, grab a pillow. Step two, grab a blanket. Step three, keep dreaming. I think we already discussed this. You're welcome. Now, if only I could... Oh, never mind. I did manage to get out. And someone should really cover that. That is just a disaster waiting to happen. Thank God there is no Frank Grimes in this workplace. Actually, don't thank God. Thank Yohane. Poor Philemon. Good for you, kid. Good for you. Screw gender stereotypes. Right, Jerry? Well, until you're out of breath. Or dehydrated. If you don't like him, then why were you hoping he would still be around? Thank you. Homework doesn't mean much in an empire ruled by, or in a world ruled by not Nazis. Give us weapons and armor that would be vastly inferior to what we'd find on our travels. Don't try to tempt fate. Just saying. It has a way of working itself out in the worst possible fashion. Dang it. I don't know. The US has developed a lot, and it still clings to some outdated notions. Okay, let's screw with this kid. I don't know if I'd be so quick to be the leader. Being number one sucks. It means you have to make a lot of tough decisions that everyone will judge you for. And that sounds awful. Or at least, I think it does. It's your own fault. Beats doing homework like your mother wants you to. Drink responsibly. I mean, there's always making her watch crappy anime, like the worst we can find. And she has to sit and watch them all while we monitor her mind. I could think of plenty of punishments that are a fate worse than death. And if she's dead, she can't experience them. I think I'm gonna end the episode here. This has been UltraGamerJ signing off, hoping to see you all in the next video, and please remember to like and subscribe for more content.